Like many Filipinos, former Ambassador Benedicto Yuhuico, president of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, saw photos circulating online of crowds gathering in malls during the first weekend under modified enhanced community quarantine. Yuhuico reveals while many of PCCI's nearly 2,000 members opened up their mall-based stores, most of them did not make any money.
Some of our members said, well, why did we still open if in fact no one is going to buy? We will lose more money paying our workers here, sales ladies, because if this is going to continue and if no one is going to walk into our shops, this is not an overnight process. It is not a switch that now we turn it on and everything will go back to normal. Certainly not. First of all, there will have to be consumer confidence that has to be rebuilt.
Yuhuico couldn't say how long it would take to rebuild that confidence, but he did say it would depend on a lot of factors, including the success of COVID-19 containment efforts. His personal estimate? 3 to 6 months. That's a problem because he says PCCI members are worried they won't last that long under current conditions.
I don't think that substantial businesses have started to close. What I can tell you is that a lot of them are telling us that without the financial assistance that they think they need, very soon, meaning in 1 or 2 months, there's no option for them but to shut down.
Manulife Asset Management's Mark Canizares says the confidence will start to return once COVID-19 infection rates flatten and the risk of a second or even third wave of infections starts to dissipate. But that will require several things, including, many argue, mass testing. Representative Stella Kimbo is pushing the Philippine Economic Stimulus Act, or PESA, bill to help restore the economy by improving consumer confidence and providing safety nets for millions of small businesses. The proposal includes 20 billion pesos in funding for mass testing, which Kimbo says will be vital to the recovery and will be too costly for the public to handle alone.
This person was charged an additional 8,000 pesos just for the tests, for the dentist, for the dental assistant, for the PPEs. That's just the additional, right? So wala pa dyan yung cost ng mismong service. Government needs to step in to try to ease that burden. Right? We're not saying, again, it's really going to now be a burden that's going to be shared by both the private sector and the government.
PCCI is conducting a nationwide survey to determine how its members are doing 2 months into one of the longest COVID-19 lockdowns in the world. But right now, it appears the easing of lockdown conditions won't help boost business unless consumers believe it's safe to get back into the marketplace. Juan de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.